Hi everyone, welcome to You Guys to Think Twice. This is Monica and I'm doing our August readings. This will be for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. Thanks for being patient with me, guys. My work has taken over my life. I feel like I'm not doing anything else other than work and then hopefully sleep. I'm gonna have to work something out because I miss you guys and I miss doing readings. So I'll have to figure it out. But hopefully you're doing well. So let's see what's going on with Virgo in August 2021. Remember to watch your sun, your moon, your rising. Keep an open mind for the messages that come through. Take them as they resonate. And information on private readings, all that is always in the description box below. Let's see, Virgo in August. What's going on for Virgo in the month of August? 2021. Okay, there we go. I'm using the Gilded Tarot Royale. I'm using a different deck for each sign this month because I thought I have so many decks and I don't really use them as much as I should. So I thought, let's try something different. Okay, Virgo. Judgment, Lovers, oh god, Six of Wands, Four of Swords, King of Swords, Temperance, Strength, Queen of Wands, the Star, the Fool. What are you doing, Virgo? What are you up to? Quite a few majors. Bottom of the deck, the Devil. Oh man, okay. For some of you, this is the ex coming back. Yes, that guy, and yes, that girl who is just like a drug, you can't let him go. Or vice versa. We have the energy of Capricorn, we have Gemini, Sagittarius, Aquarius, Leo, Aries, everyone's there, right? You don't actually have cup cards, although you do have a lot of majors, so. Okay, so, yeah. The moon. Cancer energy. Someone has been obsessing about you. Like, obsessing. They can't let you go. They can't stop thinking about you. You're not with this person. You haven't spoken to them in a while, 4 weeks, 4 months. Even if it's 4 years for some of you, it doesn't feel like it. It still feels like yesterday. They've been doing a lot of thinking. They've been trying to ignore their emotions. They've been trying to analyze this to death, right? Tell themselves it's not right, tell themselves it's this and that and the other, to talk themselves out of it. It's not been working. The more they thought about it, the more they wanted to talk to you, and you're going to hear from them quite soon with the Judgment card, because this is your current situation. So if you haven't already heard from them, you will do in the next few days. The challenge, or what's going to help or hinder the situation, is the Lovers. You have such a bond with this person, and that can be a really good thing if you're both on the same page, but it can be such a bad thing because it becomes toxic. You lose yourself, you lose yourselves in each other, or you lose yourselves along the way when you're together. Like I say, there's been a period of no contact, no communication, but just confirmation that this is something coming back or someone coming back. The Four of Swords is temporary pause. You take a step back from the battle to lick your wounds, patch your wounds up, have a little bit of a rest because you're going to go back out there in a minute. Right? And here they are, Six of Wands. I feel like they're feeling very confident when they come to you because it's like, I've thought this out, I've thought this through. I got a plan. They may shower you with attention and affection, you know, put you up on a put you back up on the pedestal. Someone's coming in like no is not even an answer, right? That's how they're coming in. Like, it has to work. It's gonna work. It has to work. I've thought it through. Does that make sense? In the near future, we have Temperance. Now, with Temperance, it can play out a few different ways. For some of you, this is the blending of the two coming back together. This is reconciliation around mid-month. The beginnings of it, right? So seeing each other, getting to know each other again, etc. For others of you, this is seeing each other or talking to each other and saying, I need more time. I need to figure it out. You've thought about it. Great. I need to think about it. So someone's asking for more time. In the position representing you, we have the Strength card. You're trying to temper yourself, Virgo. You're trying to control yourself. You're trying to prevent yourself from just going back into the pattern. You're trying to be wiser. So you could be, you know, the one saying, I need some time to think about it. In your environment, we have the Queen of Wands. The Queen of Wands in the environment, I feel like this is someone keeping an eye on the situation. It's someone external, right? So it's either someone who has an eye on you and they're waiting to see what you do with this other person, or it's someone who has an eye on this other person and it's almost like they're waiting for you to turn them down so they can jump in. Does that make sense? In your hopes and fears, we do have the Star card. So you haven't fully given up on this. You still have hope for it. You still have hope that you can heal it together. The fear is, I hope I'm not being blindsided, and I hope I'm not being gullible. In the outcome, though, we do have the Fool. And I'm not seeing the Fool as turning your back from the situation. I'm seeing the Fool as someone who is going to take a chance and jump in. Why? Because it is such a beautiful bond. I feel like the issue might have been communication, or the issue might have been someone was emotionally unavailable, or the issue might have been someone playing games, mind games, because they were confused within themselves. They may have chosen someone else with the Two of Wands. They may have chosen this Queen of Wands, and that's why she's around. And it's like, nope, change my mind. This does not make me happy. Six cups under that. I need to go make it right with Virgo. Because that's where my heart is. I don't care how long it's been, and I can't keep thinking about it and not do something about it anymore. I feel like the intensity of the connection, and because of how things played out, that is what makes this person think, and maybe you as well, that this is toxic. However, it's in your hands with the Temperance to figure it out, to meet in the middle, to keep your individuality and work together. I feel like that was an issue in the past. You just lost each other, or you just went too far left, or one just gave in to the other. It just, you know what I mean? But I feel like there is a way to make this work. It has to do with, again, maintaining your individuality and working together. Having my life, you have your life, and then we have our life. If you can come to that, this can be an amazing connection and not end badly as it did before, right? Sheesh, that's intense. Okay, let's see. Yeah, let's see. Temperance around mid-month. Yeah, the Hierophant. They're like, nope. Enough time has gone by. I've tried other things. Talked to other people. It's only reaffirmed to me that you are where my heart is. You are who I want to be with. This is very, it's a little soppy or dramatic, but that's what it is, okay? That's what it is. We have the energy of Taurus here, but also someone who is determined, right? It's not, because when you see the Six of Wands, it can't be someone who's cocky, right? There's no way Virgo's gonna say no to me. But combined with this, they're not cocky, they're determined, right? Who is this Queen of Wands in your environment? The High Priestess. Yeah, someone who is secretly keeping an eye on the situation. Someone who's a little, like, hidden and just waiting to see what happens. Could be a secret admirer of yours, of theirs. The Fool and the Outcome. Yeah, the World. See? The Fool and the World, first and the last major arcana. The Page of Wands. Yeah, okay, let's talk about this. Page of Wands is also, okay, let's try it. Let's try it. That's what the Page of Wands is. Let's try it. No expectations, no judgment on this. Let's make it something different. Let's make it something new. Let's not pick up where we left off, right, with a full clean slate, start from scratch. This is my let the past be the past, right? This is my let that cycle be complete. Let's not look at that cycle. Let's start fresh based on who we are now. And it can be a completely different experience than what it could be, what you think it could be, what you think it should be. It can be that. Jesus, Virgo, what are you dealing with? I'm a Virgo moon. I kind of think I know for me, but yeah, you're going to have to give me some feedback on this one. And listen, if it's not love, because not everyone's dealing with love, this is about a choice that you have made to walk away from something because it was too intense, too much to handle. You've chosen something else because you thought it was better, but you could never get the other option out of your head and out of your heart. Now, this could be where you walked away from a dream of yours, to go a more conservative route because that's the safer option, and it just doesn't make you happy. And you come to a point with the Six of Cups, you come to a point where it's like, no, and the Five of Swords under that, and the Justice Card under that. I refuse to compromise. I don't want to compromise anymore. If it doesn't make me happy, I'll cut it out of my life. I don't want to find bits that make me happy and deal with the bits that I'm not thrilled about. No, I've already found what made me happy, and I walked away from it. And no matter what else I try, no matter who else I'm talking to and what else I'm doing, that is still in my heart and on my mind, no matter how long it's been. And I feel like August is the month, and this could be you, Virgo, where you do this, go get someone else, right? I feel like it's the other way around for most of you, but take it as it resonates. Yeah, so it's like, that's it. No, I have to try this. I have to give it another shot, because I feel like there's another shot in there, you know? There's one more time in there. Okay, that's intense. Alright, so I'll leave it there, Virgo. Let me know what this is. But I do hope you have a great month ahead. Trust yourself, trust your instincts. At the same time, don't hold yourself back from being happy, okay? Trust that you're wiser. Trust that you can make different choices. Trust that you can see the red flags this time. Trust that you are different. And so the situation is going to be different. You know what I mean? So I'll leave it there. Watch your sun, your moon, your rising. Have a great month, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.